Hello everybody, GrayStillPlays, and we're back with more Eden Star, no time for BS. So, a couple of things have changed here. I got the base in a new position, and the reason for that is because the base that, the area that we had for the base before, and by the way, that is really cool up there, that kind of planet and this visage. The place that we had for the base before was fine, but it wasn't close enough to a lot of the different material nodes that you really need to have, I think, as you advance in the game. We needed to be closer to more protonite and— whoa! Jesus! Good gravy! Get you out of here. We needed to be near more protonite, we needed to be near more tenel, and more bridgmanite as well. That's kind of where I got us at now. I'll show you the new place for the base in just a second. I also got us— I can see you around here somewhere, you sucker. Throw your ass into the ground, take your morsel while I'm at it. That sounds dirty. I found a couple of new items that I have for us in the base. Very important as well. If you do end up playing this game, I would definitely go ahead and, as soon as you can, get a Fabricator online and get an Armory online, because they allow you to make a lot of very important things. One of which is the ability to make like protein bars for food, make health packs for health, but even better than protein bars and health packs, I feel, is the plain old cooked meat. Man, that cooked meat works really good. We need a lot of protonite, so I'm gonna grab the hell out of all the protonite I find. After we kind of like blow up everything in this area, after we destroy all of the natural resources as human beings tend to do. I think we have some Capri nuts. Capri nuts are really good for just like natural sustenance regaining. They don't really do much besides regain you sustenance. We're gonna need some more cooked meat and stuff too, but all that's back at the base. So I'm gonna start heading that way. As I see these plants, I will blow these up. Like I had said before, the smaller trees seem to have a better supply of protonite than the bigger trees. I do also want to get some of these bitter seeds just in case they have anything important that I will need. Now, the base is not very close to where we spawn. There's a reason for this too. The area that we spawned at is random until you create a spawn point, which I think is called a replicator, if I remember correctly. I do want to get a lot more ironite, though. Ironite is what I'm going to use to make our armor. I wanted to get rid of the ping display that was in, like, kind of the upper middle portion of the screen, too. I just found out K apparently gets you that. I must have hit that by accident. Grabbing more bridgmanite, more ironite whenever we can. The other thing that the Fabricator does, which is really awesome, is it turns fiber into protonite, or rather, it extracts protonite from fiber. It also extracts ironite from bridgmanite, which is really sweet. If we can get an entire suit of armor, though, I would like to really do that. We are getting quite a bit of ironite. For the biggest piece of the suit of armor, which is the cuirass, it takes, I think it was 30 pieces of ironite. So it is pretty substantial when it comes to the ironite, but the greaves, and I think the— what else was there? There was greaves and maybe vambraces or something. Only took like 10. I think maybe like 10 pieces of ironite, so not that bad at all. If we can get some seeds as well, I'd like to do that. The reason why is seeds are used for just about everything health and food-wise in this game. So it's kind of like you're going to want it all the time. The vesicles are fine too. We can squeeze those out for some water. Because as you can tell here, ooh, right over here, this is going to get us some seeds and possibly some plasma fire as well. You can see right there actually a little bit of plasma fire hanging around. Always get some seeds from these pods though. I think there's a critter around here too. There is. Let's get him out of here. Just kind of slammed him against the wall. There we are. Take your morsel from you while we're at it. That's right, you mess with Gray, you get your frickin' morsels jacked. Maybe next time you'll know better. The seeds are useful for just about everything, like I said, food and health-wise, so we do want to grab them when we see them. If we come across any tenel, I might grab that as well. Let's keep running here, just so I can get the opportunity to show you some of the base. I also put us next to some water, which I found to be very important as well. Water, having coral, and also ceramic. Coral, very good for extracting clean water out of dirty water. The planet has dirty water that you can harvest. It's just like the water, I don't know, in its natural environment. Right there, you that little blue beam, that's going to be our area. So right here, you can see this water. We can just take dirty water if we want. See that? Also, there are rock formations in the water. We can't seem to grab those, but sometimes there are rocks that you can grab. Let me see if there's any around here. I don't think any of this. The rocks that I've seen that you can grab look more like regular rocks than anything else. I think that there's a little stalker guy around here somewhere, someone being all stalkerific. Ooh, we have a whole plethora of seeds right here, or a potential plethora of seeds. Let me throw you out of here real fast so I can try and get all of this fire. Oh, wow. It went right into the water. Let's dunk on down here to see if we can grab some of it. Oh, that was a morsel. I think some of the plasma fire ended up going flying out into the middle of nowhere. You can get jacked. I think I've had enough of these guys for right now. I won't mess any more with these guys. There we go. More seeds. Yes. A lot more seeds. A little bit over here as well. I can see. This is a great area for these pods. Holy crap. Whoa. All right there, Fido. Take a chill pill, man. I can see this having bounced way the hell over here. I don't know if I really wanted to go this far for one damn seed. Oh, wow, that is way over there. Look at how far this crap goes. Physics games. Physics-based games. Very interesting. The only issue is that, oh, that's cool. We slammed one against the other, and we got all of their morsels. Let's continue onward. I do want to get back to the base. I end up getting sidetracked because throwing people around is freaking fun. A couple of other plants over there. I don't really care about all that. Let's see if we can get past all this. There we go. Ceramic right there next to the water. You can see right there where there's a whole bunch of ceramic. This is normal rock formations over here. And if we can head... Oh, it's a little... look at this. A little waterfall. I didn't see that before. Isn't that cute? Looks nice. More Bridgmanite, if we ever need it. I think that there's some tennel that lies around here as well. I won't mind grabbing some of these Capri nuts and more vesicles as well. Yeah, a lot of tennel over here. You can see, man. Oh, we always need tennel. In fact, I don't have any tennel on me. If we can get a power generator down, I think we can get a third turret down, which would be really neat, but I think we need like 30 tennel in order to make this happen. So let me go ahead and grab at least 30 tennel. There we go. I see we got a little guy on us kind of wandering around here. Our hydration levels are low. That's not going to be an issue at all, though. We're going to have plenty of hydration in just a little bit once I get back to our damn base. Got to get past all this area, though. What is that? Is that a hive that generated right next to our base? That? I don't think that was there before. Hold the phone. In a damn minute. That hive was definitely not there before when I made this base. I think we're going to have to deal with this. I have never dealt with a hive. I don't know what happens. Whoa! Alright, there's a lot of guys. That is a lot of guys. Oh my god, they're everywhere. Hold on. I need to seek the sanctity over here of our base. Get rocked, fool! Yeah! Grab all this plasma fire around here while we're at it. Give me that damn plasma fire, man. And I think we might be able to get some caprice and stuff as well. So can I damage this? Oh, I think I can throw them against their own hive, maybe? Whoa! Good gravy! Oh, these guys are everywhere. We are going to have to figure out a way to deal with this, and I have no idea how we're going to do it. Wow, that is a lot. That is a lot of plasma fire. Ouch. Okay. Okay. We're gonna have to make a gun or something. This is ridiculous. So. That's great. We have a freaking hive about 2 feet away from our base, which is nice. Keep throwing these guys around so we can grab all this plasma fire. Oh, I love all this plasma fire, though. I think that this is really going to be useful for doing a lot of different things. Get rocked! Oh, good gravy. Nope. Up you go. Upsa-daisy. Okay, let's start crafting over here because this is getting completely out of hand. Inside the armory here, what can we make? We're gonna need a firearm of sorts, even if it's just like a crappy firearm. We can make this submachine gun. That would be nice. Let's start crafting that. And from here, what would you use for the receiver? Heavy receiver, a sidearm receiver. Oh, I see. So all these have differences in range and stuff like that. So for this, we need polymer. Actually, we need polymer for everything. All right, let's start making some polymer. So over here by the fabricator, if I can do it. There we go. Not inventory. There we go. Now we're going to want inventory. Is where you can make a lot of different items. Right over here, we should have polymer. There we go. So it takes fiber and ceramic. Let's get a bunch of this being made. We'll put more meat and some of the water that we have down here. In fact, we can probably drink some of this water. We'll get some more water being made as well. There we go. A little bit of polymer made. Let's see if we can access the crafting area with our newfound polymer. High-powered receiver. How about just a regular sidearm receiver, maybe? All this takes magnetic alloy. Let's just make this. Real simple one. We'll see if we can put a gun together with this. Now, I've never done this before, so I really don't know how this works. Okay, I found out what we needed. We also need a stock. So we need a couple more polymers for this. Let's go back over here. So there is a crafting element to this game. Let's actually craft a couple of polymers here because it seems like we always need. I hear something growling at me too. Hopefully it's nothing that wants to, like, you know, take my face off or anything. Sustenance levels are getting low, but we should be able to make some different meats and things in a little bit. Gotta learn to get a little bit closer to the crafting station. There we go. So right here, a nice light stock. Let's go ahead and make one of these. That forms pretty damn fast, it looks like. So with a light stock, now I think we have all of the items, you would figure, that you could use to make the weaponry. Okay, so once you have your items, you can see it says combine the parts in the assembly tab. Obviously, this is the assembly tab. So for this, we have to put the barrel and then the receiver. So we assemble this here. And then we have a MAC pistol. Okay. So now that we have that, can you put like a... Can you put anything else on this? Because we have this stock here as well. We have this weapon now. Let's see what happens when you get yourself a weapon. Can you, like, attach this or do anything else unusual to it? Doesn't look like you can. So we have this little pistol. Little tiny pistol. Maybe we put this over here. Nope, not at all. Assault, high-powered, heavy. And then this just uses small caliber ammo. Oh, all right. Well, let's make some small caliber ammo then. So this is small caliber ammo. Requires gunpowder and ironite. Go ahead over here. Go over to the gunpowder area. This needs bismuthite and plasma fire, does it? And how much do you get? 5? All right, let's make 2 chunks of this. Bring our water and stuff over here too. We got a little bit more polymer you can see there as well. I think we've got some Capri nuts around here that we can eat should we need to. And we do need to because our satiation level there, our hunger level is kind of going down a little bit quick. There we go. So now we've got a crap ton of gunpowder. Let's go see what we can make with it. Over here at the small caliber ammo. So we can make 3 chunks of this. And that'll get us 36 ammo each time. Very good. Alright, so do you put this over here? Nope, I guess you just have to have it on you. Fair enough. So if we click 4, there we go. Now we got a little weapon. Sweet. So can we hit this from here? Yep, sure can. It's gonna take a long time though. It is gonna take a long time to take down that hive though, holy crap. A long time to take down that hive. But I guess if we work long enough at it, we'll get it. Might as well use our module, though. Our module, I think, does a little bit more damage in the grand scheme of things at the moment. Might as well grab this cartilage, though. Man, we have a renewing source of cartilage while we're here. That's kind of nice. I also have the fixer-upper kit, I guess you can call it. If we go over here to the, let me see, was it the fabricator? I'm pretty sure it was the armory. We go over here to the armory. You can see all these different items it creates, it gives you different abilities that you can use. And I happen to have the regeneration module equipped. So if we go over here to the Eden kit, I can actually hold down E and I can regenerate this. You can see where it says regen 2 seconds, 1 second, and then you just have to pay the cost. So there you go. All freshly regenerated for now. We've got 3 minutes to kind of do stuff in. Let me see if I can, let's go over here to Q, over to our crafting area. Let me see here. We got a power generator. I can make it out of tennel. I can make it out of ironite. And it looks like those are the only two things that I can make it out of. I guess I'll go ahead and make this out of tennel for right now. More power generation. That would be fantastic. There we go. That gives us 550 instead of 200 power generation. That's going to allow me to get another turret online. Oh, that is going to be really, really valuable. While we go out real fast looking for more items, let's see if we can make some stuff here. This paladin, the paladin cuirass for that. We'll go ahead and do this. And can we make anything else? Could we make maybe some of the boots or something? Oh, we need 10. We need 10 for all that. We can also use our fabricator over here. If you remember, we can extract protonite from fiber. So let's extract some protonite. And we can extract some ironite from the bridgmanite. So we'll get that going. This way, like, something is doing, you know what I mean? Like, it's happening all of the time at the very least. Like, we're always having something being crafted. Let's move down here and continue to collect more of the bridgmanite and ironite. This is one of the reasons I like this area that I've chosen. It's so close to a lot of different items that we're going to need, like the bridgmanite and the ironite. And now we have a whole slew of plasma fire since we've got that hive sitting right next to us. But man, we are going to need way more powerful weapons than just a tiny little pistol. We are, like, seriously going to have to start working on getting a weapon that is much more impressive. That's for damn sure. Got about 1 minute left until the nighttime comes, and you guys know what happens when nighttime comes. All hell is going to break loose. Come on, man. Give me another piece of ironite. One more piece of ironite, damn it. I think we need 20 to get anything done. There we are. Oh, what happened to you? Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Bam! That's what you get for looking at me wrong. Give me your morsel. Back over here by the armory. Let's see here. We're getting some stuff done. Oh crap, we don't have a lot of time left. We'll get these boots done, and hopefully this will be done in time. We've got 32 seconds left. I don't think I'm going to have enough time to make the, I don't think I'm going to have enough time to make what I want to make. Let me go over to defenses. Tennel, we do not have enough tennel at all. We don't have enough ironite either, and you can't make it out of bridgmanite. This should be done in just a second though, extracting the protonite and the ironite, which, man, I could really use right now. Please get done with this BS. Oh crap. All hell has started. All hell has broken loose. Here we go, boys. Get you out of here. Get you out of here. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. They're everywhere. Oh, give me all your plasma fire, you bastard. Oh yeah. Plasma fire for days. And we got these guys coming in as well. Jesus. Out with you. Nope. You two, get on out of here. Oh my. Maybe if I kite them, that'll help. This is actually fairly powerful. Does quite a bit of damage. Oh, we're out of ammo already? Woohoo! Look at all that! Look at all that! You gotta be kidding me! 35 health left. Oh, this is terrible. Okay, we are gonna need a lot more turrets if we want to survive. Ah! What the hell is that thing? Is that a turret of its own? I don't even know what that is. It is non-stop freaking bedlam right now. Yep, that appears to be its own turret. Like a biological turret. Okay, hold on. I need to run. Our eating kit. Little bit of damage. That was done. Let me get you out of here. Ouch. 25 health left. Well, maybe where I put the base wasn't such a good idea. Stop beating up my eating kit. How's the eating kit doing? Oh, it's still in one piece. Oh man, I can't even hear myself talk right now. There is so much happening. More cartilage. Cartilage laying all over the place. A little bit more cartilage over here. There we go. Maybe I'll use this ability. Oh my god. There we go. That seems to be working fairly well. Oh god. Energy depleted. This is insane. Oh, tower defense game. For real. Oh! I don't know how we're gonna survive this. Get out of here. It's all a matter of getting rid of them before they blow up. Another minute and a half to go. Just to see if we can survive 26 pieces of plasma fire. Not too shabby. God, this is ridiculous. Ow. We're at 4 health right now. Let's see, do we have any pieces of meat here that I can eat? Eat a couple of these real fast. Just to get a little bit of health left. How's our eating kit? I'm gonna go ahead and heal. No! Oh my god. This game. All right. Well, I highly underestimated how completely ridiculous this game can get. We are gonna have to remember that for our next time. Building a base. I'm also going to have to make sure to build a base not next to a hive. I'm not lying though. That hive was not there when I built that base. I think I would have taken a little bit more due care when I did it. But that is Eden Star. The insanity never stops. We got a little bit further to check out some of the additional instances like the armor crafting and the fabricator, but I just didn't get a lot of time to put it to use. Folks, I hope you're enjoying Eden Star and the bedlam that it contains. I want to get a bigger base so we can really start to see some of the real insanity that can get going when you have a lot of turrets online. Until next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.